first thing I want to do, how many of you have ever read Alice in Wonderland? If you remember, Alice came to a fork in the road. And she's looking left and looking right and trying to figure out which way to go. And she sees up in the tree this Cheshire cat. And she says, which way should I go? And the cat says, well, where do you want to go? And Alice said, I don't know. And the cat says, so then it doesn't matter, does it? Many of you are in the exact same situation. You are at crossroads. You don't know where you want to go. So any road won't get you there. What I want to help you do today is start to put together some of the thoughts about where you want to go so you can get there on purpose. The future is not, and I emphasize, not a continuation of the past. Tomorrow is going to look different, it's going to work different, it's going to feel different, and it's going to be different. As a matter of fact, your current success may be the biggest problem to your future because you believe you know how it's done. You believe that you know what's coming. If we do not change, make no mistake, you're going to fail. The world around you is changing at a rapid pace. But if you wait to change, the best you can do is follow others. If you are willing to embrace change, not only will you survive, but you will lead your industries. This is scary. Accelerate failure. I'm serious about that. People need to be able to try things. If you study something to death, you will never get it done. So what you want to be willing to do is when you come up with a new idea because you've been through this thinking, dream it, try it, get feedback, fix it, and keep retrying it. Only when you feel you've reached an 80 or 85% do you go through the implementation. Internal, external, this is the best way. And what I usually tell people is the faster you fail, the less it costs. And then you spend your time and effort building on success instead of prolonging the marginal. And too many of you have marginal things that you prolong for a long time. When you're ready to put something in the market, test it with your best. Find a best customer and say, would you be willing to help us? Most of them will love it because they're going to get extra care. They're going to get extra benefit. Test with your best. Get them a head start. Get their feedback. Give you a competitive edge. And then when you're done with that, you implement it. You put it out to the rest. So here's the question. Will all of this stuff work? The reality is it all works. It just depends on how you put together the puzzle. These conversations that we're having right now, if you will take these back to your businesses tomorrow, next week, whenever you get there, and start having the conversations with your employees, guess what? They know a lot of the answers. But they've been put down so many times in the past that they're afraid to give them to you. So you have to be welcoming for ideas. You have to be willing to let somebody tell you that you as the owner might have been wrong way back when you forgot to tell people to stop doing that closet report. You have to own up to your responsibility to lead the organization. These conversations are wonderful. They will help you go far. But a lot of people working for you want to be busy because they believe that makes them important and it sets them up for promotion. In reality, what you want to do is start reducing the busy work. You don't want people to be busy doing. You want people to get things done, to get the goods out to the customer, to get it done in the fastest, most effective way possible. And you can only do that if you get rid of busy work. Leadership is identifying what to do. Management is getting it done. Managers get paid for one thing and one thing only, and that's to move numbers. Leadership has to make sure that the managers know what numbers they need to move, what direction to move them in, and how far to move them. If you give your managers that information, and they're allowed to identify, where are we today? Where do we want to be? What's the time frame? How much money are you going to give me to move the numbers, and how we're going to reward people? They're going to do amazing things for you. When you're looking at procedures, the next thing to think about is the KISS principle. Now, I know a lot of people think they know what KISS stands for. Does anybody want to be wrong? Don't even try. It stands for keep it short and simple. There is nothing stupid about KISS. Anytime you look at a procedure, anything you can do to shorten the process will make you more efficient and more effective at everything we do.